Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the most obsessed of them all? Arion for my man Carrie, or Martell, little buddy Ho? Oh, Martiana, bust it down. Let's get into it.
Welcome to my channel, baby. Sip Sensibility. Welcome to my channel, baby. Sip Sensibility.
Hey, this is Sensibility Speaks. Thanks for stopping by and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
So first and foremost, I have to say this before I even begin to just touch the surface and try to unpack just slightly the BS that I heard as it relates to the audio with Nay from original Straight No Chaser and Arion. I just have to say that Martell Holt is a scum of the mother effing earth. That Bama is, was, still is jealous, envious, and projecting on his insecurities, things that possibly happened to him as a child, onto Melody. So before I get into Martell's insecurities and what he's trying to project on a Melody, let me speak to this as it relates to Arion. So she actually denied Little Knox the opportunity to film in Destin, Florida with Martell and Melody and the kids. And I'm glad that she did, because had that little boy gone, I don't think production or Carlos, Kingdom Rain, or whoever, or even Martell with his slick ass, I don't think they would have told her that the little boy was coming. And so it would have been on film, blindsiding her, okay? They wanted to see her real time. They wanted to see the countenance, the look on her face of how she would react by seeing that little baby. That's some dirty shit, Carlos and them. That's some dirty ish. And then to have the Scots come too, so they can see the shit. Come on now. That's some lowdown ish right there. But for God, honey, child, only thing I can say for what, every five demons, Melody has thousands of angels and blessings bestowed upon her. That wasn't nothing but the act of God that Arion had an ounce of sense to not to let the little boy film. So it's not that she was trying to protect Melody. Let's be clear. Don't get it twisted. She just mad because her ass won't film it, okay? So anyway, let's get back to what Martell is trying to project, okay? He's telling his story and trying to transmute bullish that's happening to him and to project it onto her. We don't know if what he alleges happened to Melody as a child, and I'm not going to get graphic here because I thought it was utterly effing disgusting. And if it did actually happen, which I don't think it did, and prayerfully it did not, and you can read between the lines, God bless her. And I know she's been through therapy for other reasons. And if in fact it did happen, that she's on the other side of it all as best she can be. God bless her and God help her and continue to wrap his loving arms around her. But as far as Martell, I think that happened to him as a child, because that Bama hates women. He despises women, and namely Melody. Now, see, I peeped him long time ago. He was a follower of Kevin Samuels, and we all know what he stood for, okay? That whole modern woman and modern man bullish, and that whole manosphere rhetoric, that hate rhetoric toward women. And as far as those Kevin Samuels followers, those incels who are involuntarily celibate, i.e. incel, okay? They hate women because they have mommy issues. They don't have access to the women that they want. But anyway, it's a whole plethora of issues with those Bamas. But let me tell it, little buddy, Martell, he has the Oedipus complex. He has mommy issues and they're deep rooted. And he projects them onto women and some other issues I'll get into. But let me continue. And oftentimes, many of us say it's spiritual warfare that Melody is experiencing with Martell. And I really think it is. He is a straight up demon. He is demonic. He's Satan's spawn, and Arion is his evil ass twin flame. He manifested her, literally, a female version of himself. And she is willing to go as low as he is in order to take Melody down.
But you know, as I've said before in past videos, Martell devolved down to his own level. Water seeks his own level. Well, he devolved down to the bedbug, child. But anyway, let's get into this damn audio, shall we?
Again, let me just reiterate that. I believe he was touched as a child, and I don't know to what extent, allegedly, and in my opinion, okay, just based upon his mannerisms, his behavior, and I'm going to let you guys hear a snippet of a little video, because I've heard this many times. Men who are womanizers, who treat women like ish and dog the hell out of women, and they have an insatiable appetite for sex, and they have like an unfulfilled need and void, like a bottomless pit down to the abyss, and they try to satisfy their needs from different women, really want men. I'm just saying.
It's not you, he's gay. He's gay, baby. Womanizers, men that fuck around on women, they fucking hella bitches, they can't find what they looking for is because they looking for a man. I'm just saying. I done been with it. I done laid in the bed with it. I done heard it. I done fucking seen it. It's not you. You cannot possibly fulfill what he's looking for. You don't have the parts. So don't blame you. Don't get in your feelings. Drop them and move on. You ain't hear that shit from me. I'm just saying. It's not you. He's gay. He's gay, baby. Womanizers, men that fuck around on women, they fucking hella bitches. They can't find what they looking for is because they looking for a man. I'm just saying. I done been with it. I done laid in the bed with it. I done heard it. I done fucking seen it. It's not you. You cannot possibly fulfill what he's looking for. You don't have the parts. So don't blame you. Don't get in your feelings. Drop them and move on. You ain't hear that shit from me. I'm just saying.
Oh, child, he spoke a whole word, didn't he? I'm just saying. But let me continue on with my little spiel about it.
A woman is not what they really want. And that's why they keep searching and searching, trying to fill that need and that void. Not to mention he's an egomaniacal, narcissistic bastard. Not to mention that, okay? And we already know he's a goddamn narcissist that needs his ego stroked 24/7, okay? And I believe the reason why he lashes out at women the way he does, because deep down, the Bama wanna be one. Deep down, that Bama rests in his feminine energy, zesting it. And that's why he has so much zeal and fervor when it comes to arguing and siphoning the energy of a woman. He wants the very essence of a woman, because deep down, the Bama want to be one, okay? You know, when I say that, I mean energetically, okay? Maybe not literally, but he desires what a woman desires, another man. Allegedly, and in my opinion, and I wouldn't be surprised if the rumors that are out there are true. And if that's the case, that's fine. Live in your truth. Because a lot of DL men, or same gender loving men, okay, that were living in a closet before they came out and just lived in their truth, treated women like ish, okay? Because deep down, they despise themselves. If you don't love yourself, you damn sure can't love me, another woman, another man, or whomever you desire. And I believe Martell is a self-loather, okay? And he reached down to the pits of hell, sharing any business of Melody's with Arianne Curry, his little bed bug that he goddamn manifested with her bird brain ass. All right, let me get into this a little bit. So after that disgusting conversation that they had allegedly of what allegedly happened to Melody, okay? So there are parts where Arianne referred to herself as being that bitch and being that chick, child, and how she excels at everything and Martell helps her excel. What the hell is he helping you excel at, hun? You still live in a Section 8 housing, and shout out to the people who have to do what they have to do to keep a roof over your head. And if that means you have to do Section 8, that's fine. But what is he helping you excel at? Shit, he's trying to bum off your damn EBT card. You dropped out of damn nursing school. You goddamn living pillar to post. You're depending on him to goddamn take care of you with his broke ass. Shit, that man ain't got two nickels to rub together. A goddamn pot to piss in, nor a house with a window to throw the mother effer out of. okay? But you trying to leech on to him. He trying to leech on to Melody and her damn money. You sorry trick? You just a sorry damn trick. You thought you saw a lick and had a damn suck in Martell, and Martell sees Melody as a damn lick, okay? But she goddamn shut his ass down, all the way effing down. Talking about something he helping you excel. Child, if he was trying to encourage you since he claimed he made Melody, then how come he can't make you? Child, what your male identified for my man ass? Let me see what else they talked about. She just as delusional as she want to be, but I can't get over how they were talking about how the kids was eating fast food, and I think Nate alleged that people dropped down to her DMs or sent her messages saying that the kids ate out. How in the hell would they know? Were they living in Melody's house and Martell's house 24/7? Was they peeking through a goddamn window morning, noon, and night for breakfast, lunch, and damn dinner? And damn during the school day too to see what the F they were eating? How in the hell would they know they were eating damn fast food? I believe someone from Arion's camp or Martell's camp probably planted those seeds, okay? Yeah, being insidious and malicious. They were being strategic and manipulative. Talking about the kids ate damn fast food. How in the hell would they know? And then for Arion to double down and piggyback on it, shit, we seen you goddamn feeding your child popsicles 2, 3, 4 in the damn morning. Shit, as if you damn mother of the year. Talking about something you feed the kids organic. I don't believe it. Shit, you probably feed yourself organic with your selfish ass. You probably eat organic, but them damn kids, you goddamn giving him goddamn Snickers and goddamn gummy pops and shit in the middle of the night. Girl, if you don't set your ass down, let me see what else they talked about. Shit. Oh, and what gets me, so Nate tried to kind of steer her a little bit because they were talking about, you know, I seen Martell's bank account and it went from $700,000 to zero. Now, I don't know if it was $700,000 that the Bama went through that quickly. I believe it was $17,000 or more than that, but I don't know about $700,000 unless they're talking about assets that weren't liquid or whatever like that. And when they dissolved businesses, it could have been valued, not liquid $700,000 when it came to properties or assets that weren't solvent or eventually they became solvent, but not liquid cash. But whatever the case may be, why in the hell is he sharing their personal financial history and personal business? Why is he sharing that with that girl? You really hated Melody so much because you despise your damn self that you wanted to take her down because you hate your damn self. I'm just saying, and I don't blame Melody for having security. I don't know if she got it 24/7, but she may want to consider it. He seemed like the type that tried to take you out for a damn insurance policy. Old Tim Norman acting ass. Child, oh, broke motherfucker. Let me see. So anyway, okay, so Arion had the nerve to say that Melody fumbled the bag. She was like, oh, she just didn't give a F. She was like, the hell with that business? So meaning whenever she was really pissed at Martell or they were just going through feuding, quarreling, going back and forth or whatever, she was just like, I'm walking away from it all because I can start over from ground zero and come back from where I was and soar like a phoenix from the ashes. I see Martell was afraid of that because he didn't have his damn business license, general contractor license or whatever, right? He depended on her to deal with the day-to-day operations of the business. We all know that she was the brains of that operations, yada, yada, yada. But for Arion to say that she fumbled the bag, no, Martell fumbled the damn bag, okay? And see, I'm just like, that Bama can say he had a goddamn cure for the panorama, the cure for cancer, and you're dumbass to believe it, child. Oh my God. I'm like, how silly can you be? Just as gullible as you want to be. So Nate was like, well, no, you got to give it to Melody. She was running the operations while he was out cheating with you. She was like, yeah, because I was with him when he was doing the property preservation. Girl, like you were shooting with them in the damn gym. So he may have been going out looking at properties or whatever to preserve, okay? Or may have been casing out leads or whatever like that. He just took your silly ass with him as opposed to you goddamn studying your damn nursing and trying to get your life together and build your career, you following down behind him with your damn mouth open, ready to goddamn bend over and to receive from either end. Get my drift, okay? You silly bitch. But anyway, no, she didn't fumble damn bag. She just walked away and got that albatross from around her neck. He was a liability with his dead weight ass. But I can't get over how she was like, no, nay, no, nay, because Martell said, I'm just like, girl, if that's the case, then why he ain't living as lavishly as Melody is, okay? Why you think he trying to beat your ass, allegedly?
every so often to take out his damn frustration because you ain't Melody and you ain't truly what he want. Y'all might be fumbling around with toys and things like that and little kinky things that he may like. I believe he's into some different shit, okay? And he might get you to experiment and goddamn do the different shit. Read between the lines if y'all catch my drift, child. But I think he want the real thing. And I don't think you got the parts for that, Arion. You might strap up and do some other-ish. I'm just saying, allegedly. I'm just saying. I just couldn't get over the audio. Martell is a scum of the damn earth. He is a scum of the damn earth, and he's like a goddamn leech. You know how, like, you see in the movies when people get an award and they have all them damn leeches on them? He's a goddamn blood-sucking leech. That's what he is. Child, he's like scum at the bottom of the damn pond. Just pond scum. Ugh. Anyway, but the only good thing about all of the disturbing audio that Nate puts out in terms of what she recorded Arion saying, it just helps Melody build her case. But it's another thing before I go that she said, she was like, well, I couldn't just fully come for Melody because, you know, now that I'm 31, 32, I had to put myself into Melody's shoes, you know. Now, me being 31, 32, the age she was, catching her husband cheating and stuff like that, I was just like, oh, you can empathize now that you done seen him with Sheree, boom, boom, Belinda, this trick, that trick, here trick, there trick, everywhere chick, chick, okay? Now that you done seen him with other damn broads, and now that he free and single, goddamn 3-4 years, and he still ain't made an honest woman out of you, he ain't put no damn ring on your hand, you still goddamn 10, 11 years a slave, telling my son and Natasha Kate video, oh, well, you know, I got to get to know her in this new normal. If you don't get the fuck out of here and y'all got a whole 3-year-old, 2-year-old, however old little Knox is, okay? You've been lick sucking and effing this mama for over 10 years. And he said he don't know you and you done buried a whole child and aborted a few others. Girl, if you don't goddamn get your mind right with your silly ass, somebody need to just shake her and knock some damn sense into her. And just be like, girl, wake up. Wake up, little mama. Wake up. Child, anywho. But honey, if you keep your damn wagon hitched to Martell, your ass gonna end up in jail without a bail, just like his ass. I'm just saying. But anyway, y'all drop down in the comments and y'all tell me what y'all think. And again, as I said before, I believe something happened to Martell as a child. That's why he despises women. That's why he's lost. And I think he's resting in his feminine energy and he tries to fight it, but it emanates and it exudes at every damn turn. The Bama couldn't have it if he wanted to. That Bama be ready to combust at any given moment because he can't contain it. He can't contain it. Anyway, this is Sensibility Speaks. Thanks for stopping by. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Bye-bye.